Exactly. I don't judge. What's the worst thing that's going to happen if you smoke some weed? You're going to eat a couple of Twinkies and drive really safely.
White people, you have good weed. And I commend you because you use discretion. You get your weed from somebody called a guy. I don't know who this guy is. You can ask any white dude anywhere. Where you get your weed from? I get it from this guy. I see him on Tuesdays. You want me to pick you up something? That's all you get. Ask a brother, your dogs, where you get your weed from? From my cousin here at the Holiday Inn right down the street. Won't you call him from your cell phone so you can lock the number in? Then they wonder why they get caught. It's 2 o'clock in the morning and your car is orange. That's why you got caught. You need a guy.
When you get your weed from white people, they let you try it before you buy it. Can't get that from black people. You have to smoke them out with the shit you just got from them. In business, that's called reneging.
I had to go back and learn fractions just to buy weed from white people. I didn't know nothing about eighths or quarters or nothing like that. Nobody told me that if the bottom number was bigger, you get less. I had to rush down to Home Depot to get one of them rulers with the lines on them. The guy was like, what you using it for? Like, I'm buying an eight from a white guy. Which one is the eighth? Is that the little short line next to the quarter? Because I don't want to get ripped off. I want the right length. I'm on the phone telling my friends, don't worry about it. I got 2 164ths coming. We'll just put one in the freezer. This should last us till Christmas.
I have a prescription for medical marijuana. And here in Los Angeles, you don't even need a real reason to get it. The doctor's like, why do you need a prescription for medical marijuana? It's like, because my neighbor moved to Burbank. And I don't know where else to get any pot from. Because everybody smokes. I hate when I go to the store high, but the guy behind the counter is higher than I am. So you try to buy something and he's like, $2.75, please. And you're like, how much? He's like, what? My friend tried to get me to smoke some Afghani weed. I don't want to smoke Afghani weed because people in Afghanistan get stoned to death. I'm just trying to get to Hollywood.
Here's the deal.
So what we're going to try to determine, what I will try to determine, is which of the three people that we're looking at right now is high. One is high and two are not, right, Sal?
That's right.
Okay, so it's my job to figure out who is, and well, let's start by meeting these folks. Here we go. Let's start with Ryan. Ryan is your name?
It is.
Ryan, where are you from?
I am originally from San Diego, and I currently live in West Hollywood.
Okay, very good, and I see you're battling with a little puberty right now.
It's about time.
Okay, what do you do for work, Ryan?
I'm a freelancer, and I also work in hotels.
You're a freelancer, you work in hotels. Okay, well, that could mean weed dealer for sure. Freelancer works in hotels. All right, let's meet the young woman standing to your left there, and her name is Tammy. Hi, Tammy.
Hi, how are you today?
I'm good, Tammy. Wow, we got like a cartoon voiceover crew here tonight. Tammy, what do you do for work?
I'm a waitress, and I work in a kosher store.
And where do you work?
What? Mr. Kosher and Denny's.
Oh, Mr. Kosher and Denny's.
Yes, you have to live in L.A. It's expensive.
Yeah, right, I know, but that's interesting. It's quite a range of restaurants you got going there, huh?
Restaurant and grocery store.
Restaurant and grocery store.
Yes.
Okay, so you're not accidentally bringing a grand slam to a rabbi's table or something?
Absolutely not. It's not kosher.
Oh, yes, that's right. Is it kosher to work in both of those places?
I wash before and I make sure I'm kosher to go to work.
You get the bacon out of your hair.
Yes, and then I put my mouth to speak the right language.
Okay, very good. And finally, we have Ruben. Hello, Ruben.
How you doing, Jimmy?
I'm doing well, Ruben. How you doing?
Pretty good, pretty good.
What do you do for work, Ruben?
I'm a full-time student.
Okay, what are you studying?
I study business.
Okay, all right. Well, right away, Ruben seems like he'd be, like, just off the cuff, I'd go with Ruben. Maybe it's because he's wearing green. I don't know, but... Let's get real close and let's get a look at their eyes, and that's helpful for sure. Let's start with Ryan there. Okay, Ryan. Ryan is definitely hiding something. All right, now let's see Tammy. Oh, Tammy's got two jobs. I don't think she has time to be messing around with weed. And finally, Ruben. And let's take a look at Ruben, who is... Oh, yeah. I mean, come on. It's... Yeah, well, okay. I don't need... Ruben doesn't even... All he has is pupils. Ruben, I am going to say that you are high. Are you?
I'm not.
You're not! Okay. Oh, wow. Well, let's take another look. Maybe you can answer some questions here. Ryan, what did you have for lunch?
I did not have lunch.
Oh, all right. Well, then I'm going to say Tammy is my answer. Tammy, are you high?
Yes, I am.
Oh,
yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, great. There we go. And,
Let me just let you know, we need it very hard for you to smell.
Hey, I got a good sniffer.
Do you want a little snack?
Yeah.
Did you say, yeah? Okay.
These are one of my favorites.
The Flamin' Hot Cheetos.
You like spicy food?
Yeah, I like spicy food. I'm half Mexican, so. No.
I'm full black.
But just.
Do I remind you of a teacher you've ever had?
The ones that caught me smoking weed.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you only get caught once?
Yeah.
Okay, so you learned your lesson.
I mean, not really, but.
Do you like busting your shoes, Pierre?
Oh, I don't. I just felt like I had a responsibility to look out for the other students. I'm in a portable classroom, so like there's not a lot of ventilation in there, so it was like a hot box in there. Oh. And all the other kids are just like, the fuck is that?
I think you're high.
Is it because I'm black? You think I'm high?
You're black? no, the lids are kind of low.
I think you're high. Just because this comes from my father, it's called the nigga glare. And the fact that he's laughing right now means that he's probably understanding what I'm saying.
Is that cool? I mean, I feel like you're profiling.
I think he's probably high. You're just camping on the... not to bring it... You're just camping on the Cheetos.
He's high.
Did you smoke weed in high school?
No.
Oh my god, no.
Can you go to page 37?
That's 36.
Okay, 37. Cool. What's the title of this chapter?
What the Germans Lack.
Oh, okay. Good. Continue.
Among Germans, it is not enough these days to have a spirited mind.
Very nicely done. I feel like I have the answer. Is that too fast? I feel like I'm really good at this.
I don't think so. No.
I think you are not high.
I smoke weed a lot, bro. Mm-hmm. You and I almost look exactly like we shop at the same place. What's your favorite crunchy food or snack?
Carrots, you know.
Let's see the Nietzsche. Before you read Nietzsche, do you have any strong thoughts on Nietzsche?
No, boring.
Boring?
Yeah, that's the main thought, I think.
Okay, let's read this passage here.
You choose dialectics when you have no other means. You know that using it provokes mistrust, and that it is not very convincing.
So why do you think Nietzsche says it provokes mistrust and just like... I think she's high.
I don't think you're high, but you seem really fun to smoke with. Hello. Hi. I'm so sorry.
Is that a racial thing?
No, it's not a racial thing. What?
Want some Doritos?
You know what she said to me? She said, "You're a player, aren't you? And I bet you got hoes."
Say it with me.